If you're gonna hold it so I can see it. I invite you to please stand and turn toward the entrance of the church as we receive the body of Father Jim. Thank you for coming in advance, and thank you for participating and expressing your prayers, your support in this time of grieving, especially for the family and for all of us. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Father Jim died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him the eternal glory. In baptism and throughout his life, Father Jim was supported by the cross of Christ, both in suffering and in rising to glory. In his life, Father Jim cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet him with these words of eternal life, "Come, blessed of my Father." In his priestly life, Father Jim prayed for the universal church, for all of us, and for himself, with the Christian prayer, the Liturgy of the Hours, which he prayed daily.
Please join in our opening song, number 679, Carry Me Home, number 679. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of Father Jim, your servant and priest, whom you honored with the sacred office
while he lived here on earth in this world. Now may you exalt him forever in the glorious home of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the scripture reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. With what shall I come before the Lord and bow before God the Most High? Shall I come before him with holocausts, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with myriad streams of oil? What does the Lord require of you? Only this, to act justly, love tenderly, and walk humbly with your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from Paul to the Philippians. I give thanks to my God at every remembrance of you, praying always with joy in my every prayer for all of you, because of your partnership for the gospel from the first day until now. I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work in you will continue to complete it until the day of Christ Jesus. It is right that I should think this way about all of you, because I hold it in my heart. For God is my witness, how I long for all of you with the affection of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may increase ever more and more in knowledge and every kind of perception, to discern what is of value, so that you may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, for the glory and praise of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Stop judging and you will not be judged. Stop condemning and you will not be condemned. Forgive and you will be forgiven. Give and gifts will be given to you. Good measure, pressed together, shaken down, and overflowing will be poured into your lap. For the measure for with which you measure will in return be measured out to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Greetings. First of all, of course, we say our sympathy to all of Father Jim's nieces and nephews and grandnieces and nephews. We know that he held you in high regard, and we want you to know first and foremost that we will be praying for you and holding you, as that second reading said, in our hearts because of this loss of Uncle and the ways that it'll take a while to recover from that. But thanks all of you for coming. Thanks for being here, and thanks for the way that you knew and just treasure Father Jim. Thanks to all our priests for coming. A lot of them came from way out in the panhandle. I want to thank our Bishop Hanefeldt, who is presiding today, Bishop Dendinger, who is a celebrant, and most of all, I want to say, isn't it great to have Bishop Golka back here? Thank you very much. And of course, Deacon Bill Buchta, the great deacon here from St. Leo's. The church says, here's a few things that we have work to do, and here's a way to do them. So at the vigil, we say, how are we going to be without O'Kane, and how is O'Kane going to be without us? And it's the way we cherish him, and the vigil is about holding him tightly and holding him, cherishing him as much as we possibly can. So last night we did that with prayers and readings, and all, remembering all the ways that he touched us or that we know that we were treasured by him. So it's kind of a moment where that is kind of different from the funeral mass. The funeral mass is a celebration, of course, of Jesus dying and rising. And of course, we bring ourselves to that dying and rising as Father O'Kane did for so many people at the Eucharist. So the gathering that we do today, the funeral, is not so much holding on as it is the beginning to let go. Part of that letting go is what is our attachment to him, or how is it that we were attached to him that we might not be in the future. But the opening thing for the vigil last night says, you know, all the ways of our bonds and affection do not go away when someone dies. So we don't gather here because this is the end. We gather here because we're going to be in relationship with a new way. But part of our gathering also is to lift him up to the Lord and say, Lord, you know who this wonderful priest was. You know what a wonderful human being he was that you created. And we don't have to pray that too long because we know that the Lord is holding him as he held us. Father Jim O'Kane, James Dennis O'Kane, was ordained in 1965. But I didn't get to know him until 1974 when we were on the liturgy commission together. And I didn't know much about liturgy, but after I got to know him, I learned a lot and kept on learning. I mean, he was the premier liturgist of our diocese. He did the liturgy so incredibly well, and so incredibly well that you wouldn't know it unless you saw how he did it all the time and in so many wonderful ways. He was very much an introvert, but also he was somebody who, in that second reading, kind of reflected that he'd long for people. He was a very rich feeling person, and he had all sorts of feelings for himself and for other people. He was incredibly perceptive, and he could tell you how you were doing. He would say, well, it sounds like you're feeling this way, or he would know exactly how to respond to you. The gospel is kind of odd. I couldn't figure out why he chose that gospel. But Father O'Kane in his life had a lot of ups and downs. He had a lot of moments where he was not received, not just rejected, but he had a lot of moments in his priesthood of non-reception. People just did not know him and understand him. They didn't know what to do with him. Finally, they figured that out when they came to St. Leo's. Part of that, him living that and as an introvert would be, you wouldn't know what he was going through. You wouldn't know what he was suffering. And he wouldn't tell you unless you were having a drink or two or unless you were in a long ride. He just was a kind of an introvert. But he had his share of dying and rising. And he had an awful lot of things happen to him that just should not have happened to anybody. And today is the kind of day we say, you know, the Lord is going to heal him right away of all those afflictions and all those arrows that kind of left a mark. Part of who he was this incredible perception of how to attend to people. He just knew how to attend to people. So when I read this gospel and stopped judging, I thought, where did he get that from? Why was he talking about that? Well, I don't know exactly, but the antidote to judgment is acknowledgement and reception and honoring. So the gospel that comes to my mind that put me in mind of O'Kane being the opposite of that would be Jesus talking to the woman at the well. Here's this woman who has absolutely no self-concept, no self-worth. She's ostracized. She's married 4 times. And so she doesn't dare come to the well when all the other women are because they just beat up on her. So she comes to the well, and Jesus says, can you give me some water? Immediately giving her a worth. If you ask somebody for a favor, that means that you need that person. Immediately giving her a value and a worth that she never had for a long time. So Cain would have said something like, greetings, and, right? What happened to you? Are you okay? He would have figured out that she was in some type of pain or misery, and he would not have judged at all. And that is the antidote to all that judgmentalism. Every now and then, well, most of the time, people come to confession to me and they confess being judgmental. Well, it is the American indoor sport, judgmentalism, really. But in that gospel with Jesus at the woman at the well, all he does is just honor what she's been through and who she is and what she needs. And we have a few priests like that that do that, and O'Kane is one of them. He would just know totally how to honor you and hold you exactly in the way that you needed to be done. So part of the funeral celebration is we are holding O'Kane, but we're also getting ready to let him go. But we can't let him go fully until we know our God has him. Our God is carrying him home. So part of our work is to say, we know, Lord, that you have him, and we know that you're going to heal him, and we know that you'll fill him up. He will have the fullness of every dream that you gave him. He was also incredibly good at liturgy and ritual and symbol. And he was just like born to be that. Now, I don't know when he started manifesting that in the diocese, but with Vatican II, remember, he was ordained in the middle of that mishmash right after Vatican II. I mean, it was all chaos and conflicting ways, and nobody knew what to do with this stuff. So O'Kane was born into that moment. He was born into that moment to show us, here's how you do liturgy. And as somebody said last night, one of his favorite things was less is more. And he lived that out in a lot of ways. But he was so good at putting together symbol and meaning and feelings. And of course, that's the heart and soul of our Catholic faith. All these rituals and symbols that really help us to see beyond who we are, that open us up to that other world of imaginal and the unconscious, and of course, the transcendent. Bishop Golka said some wonderful things last night, but one of the things he said was, O'Kane had a perfect way, a great way of figuring out what the word was, which left you right close to mystery, and then the mystery would envelop you. Such a perfect image for symbol and ritual. But the symbol was what Golka took you with that word. He took you right to the symbol, the doorway of that mystery. And you could let that mystery overtake you, or you could back away. But O'Kane was so good at all sorts of symbols. And every now and then he'd do something, I'd say, now what'd you do that for? Well, he just said, okay. It was just so natural. It just flowed out of him. And those of you who've been longtime St. Leo's parishioners, or even in Scotts Bluff or Kearney, you know how good he was at ritual. And it was a way he had of putting all of that meaning and all of that feeling and all of that expression, external expression, together for a wonderful, powerful experience. He knew the rules of liturgy, a ritual and symbol. He knew the power of symbol, and he knew how it was a straight line to the heart if you did a symbol well. The other thing he was good at, besides being very perceptive and discerning about people and sensitive, was he loved relationships. He was just constantly wanting to be in relationship or help other people be in relationship. He's kind of the epitome of a gregarious person, if you ever thought of an introvert as being gregarious. He was always wanting to get people together or be with people in the most elegant way. And that's how he was. He was just pure, let us do this elegantly and lovingly. He could not stand conflict. He just could not stand not to be reconciled. So one of the gifts and one of the powers that he had, I don't know where he got that, but when he was in conflict with somebody, if it was really serious, he would go to that person. I only know one of the priests that would do that. He would go to that person and try to be reconciled. He just couldn't stand not being reconciled. It just was an ache for him. He just wanted to be really well with people. Finally, he treasured all the ways that he was connected with people and the ways that other people were connected with each other and with him. And one of the things he said, okay, be sure to remember this, Bridger. Okay, that is his mother's maiden name. And he said, I want you to remember that because I want you to talk about that at the funeral. Okay, this is 6 or 7 years ago. But he loved being the bridge between other people. He loved being the bridge between what other people were and how they were and how they were loved and what they needed. He was just incredibly perfect at that. You could not be around him without him knowing what's the next thing in your psyche to attend to. He just knew that so well. Several years ago, we were planning Bishop Dendinger's 75th birthday. Is that 5 or 10 or 20 years ago? I can't remember. I made the mistake of saying to O'Kane, can you help me with this? Oh, sure. So before I knew it, he had all the flowers and all the food and everything lined up at the country club. I didn't have to do anything. He just had a way of making sure everything was going to be perfectly pleasing and elegant for everybody there. And it just purely was. And it's just incredible for me to imagine what great taste he had. He had such great taste. You know, he went to architecture school. He had great taste in colors and arrangement. But liturgy was a thing. You could just see, if you went to one of O'Kane's great liturgies, you just knew what he was about. Finally, that first reading is one of his favorites from Malachi. What does the Lord require of me? Only this. Do the right thing, love tenderly, and walk humbly with your God. And today we are here to say, we know a little bit more about the face of God because of how Father O'Kane just loved tenderly. He taught us that, and we've seen somebody who knows how to love tenderly. And that's kind of our next mission, for us to love tenderly.
Please stand for the intentions. Brothers and sisters, Jesus is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
For Father Jim, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Father Jim, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased friends and relatives, and all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, and that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Father Jim, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's great kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Seated.
Please join in singing number 499, Only This I Want, number 499.
Only this I want.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all this holy church.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that through these holy mysteries, Father Jim, your servant and priest, may behold with clarity forever what he faithfully ministered to here on earth. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Christ, the hope of a blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of death and dying might be consoled by the promises of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Until you come by.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of Christ and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Leo, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for yourself. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant Jim, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, and you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace. Thanks. Thank you. Peace. Thanks for being here. Thanks, Bill.
For Holy Communion, there'll be three stations. Bishop Dendinger will be here in the middle and a cup on either side. Bishop Golka will be on this side in the middle and a cup on either side. And Bishop Hanefeldt will be over here with a cup on the right. So all of you come up to the middle and receive and then go by the side. Same thing here. The priests will come up afterwards after they start that and bring receive from the cup at the altar.
If you are not receiving communion, you may come up to get a blessing. Just simply give us a symbol of your hands crossed. If not, just please remain. Feel free to be seated during the distribution of communion. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The deacon.
Please join in singing number 503, We Remember, number 503.
Touch you and be good.
down, and oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart troubled be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. Raise me up to more than I can be. There is no life, no life without its hunger. Each restless heart beats so imperfectly. But when you come and I am filled with wonder, sometimes I think I glimpse eternity. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. Me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. Raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to more than I can be. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Let us rise and pray in thanksgiving. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we implore your kindness, O God, for Father Jim, your servant and priest, that as you made him a steward of your mysteries on earth, so you may bring him to be nourished by their truth and reality as unveiled in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. For me personally, this is a day of hope and also a day of mourning. Father Jim and I met as freshmen in college. I'm not going to give you the date, but it was slightly after the Civil War ended. So I've known him and deeply appreciated all the fine points that Father Torpy brought out. He was at and perhaps more. So it'll be a little different world without it. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother, Father Jim. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Please join in singing number 688, Song of Farewell, number 688.
Spirit to prayer, what time?
Lord, we commend the soul of Father Jim, your servant and priest. In the sight of this world, he is now dead, but in your sight, he will live forever. Forgive whatever sins he may have committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
All are invited to the luncheon, which will follow immediately. Those who are not going to the cemetery for the burial rite, feel free to go to the social hall. And when the burial is over, then the family and I and all those who went to the burial service will be here for the luncheon. So in peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Let's go forth singing number 581, soon and very soon, number 581.
Thank you.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, ex soles filii heve, a te suspiramus, gementes et plentes, in hoc lacrimarum vale. Ea ergo, advocata nostra, illos tuos, misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O dulcis Virgo Maria.
Thanks to all the priests gathered, deacons. Thank you very much.